Additional information concerning SCP-1864 Addendum 1, Initial Exploration Log, Close Log. The following communications log was collected during the initial discovery and exploration of the SCP-1864 anomaly, during which the nature of SCP-1864 was ascertained. Exploration was carried out by a three-man team of MTF Delta 9 Rock Chalkers members, designated as follows: 9TL, Agent Comma Team Leader 9A, Agent 9B, Agent, begin log, 9TL, alright, comms on. Everybody set? Silence, alright. We're entering the anomaly right now. Mark the time. 17:30 hours. MTF 9 team enters SCP-1864. No disturbances noted on visual or audio feeds. 9TL, looks like a big stone atrium, something on the ground. It's slick, be careful. Dark in here, too. Pop lights, guys. 9B, I. 9TL, silence, that's better. Sweep this room, then let's move to that exit over there. Additional silence as agents sweep room. Anybody got anything? 9A, nah, nothing really. Some scratching on the wall, might be tool marks? 9TL, noted. Silence, alright, we're good. Let's move into this hallway. MTF 9 moves into first labyrinth hallway. Initial progress is slow while team assesses the nature of the labyrinth, and early logs have been removed for brevity. 9TL, another bend over here. Hold on, what's that? 9A, words up here. Some kind of inscription? It's in German, I think. 9B, I've got it. Silence, okay, so it's directions to the center, I think. Mentions a hole, and a sickness, and somebody called Banhun. The eyes of the healer turned flesh into filth. Really disjointed. I'll get images. 9TL, think you can use those directions to get us somewhere? 9B, laughter, I'm sure it'll get us somewhere. Extraneous logs removed for brevity. 9B, more words over here, hand me that camera. 9TL, what's this? 9B, this just has the word sick written over and over again. Wait, no, there's a reference to Panhun over here, too. Put the devil in the well, Panhun cried, but they closed it on him. And 9A, shit, there's something up around that corner. Silence as team members move to view the corner ahead of them. Nothing of note visible on video recording. 9TL, quietly, okay, there's another way over here. Stay quiet. Team moves to a different hallway. No mention is made of the previous disturbance. 9B, after some time, so is that. 9TL, I. Let's keep moving. Team moves silently for a time, occasionally pausing around corners. 9B leads the way, occasionally glancing at his notes. 9TL, comma, there's more over here. Something in the wall, too. 9B, pauses. Banhun was a good boy. Panhun said he only wanted to serve the Kaiser. Panhun was sick, but not as sick as he saw us. And more mentions of Banhun. You know, I don't know if these were carved into the wall originally, or somebody came along and did it, because that's a lot of chiseling, you know? 9TL, I was thinking the same thing. Here, this was stuck in this nook. A lot of notes, I can't read it. 9B, it's a scientific journal. Silence, Dr. Gregory Grosswald. Just flipping through it, there's more mention of Panhun in here, too. Worth holding onto, anyway. 9TL, yeah, keep that. Let's go, silence. Both 9TL and 9B turn to face 9A, who is staring down the hall in front of them, unmoving. 9TL draws his sidearm slowly. 9TL, comma, walk backwards slowly. Don't look away from it. Comma, you 9B, I know. All team members continue to stare down the hall, which appears vacant on video feeds. No sound is detected aside from that of the team members. 9A, I. It's gone? Did you see? 9TL? Yeah. Let's not stay too long here. Any more directions on that wall? ?9B, yes. I'm noting them right now. Extraneous logs removed for brevity. 9B, you guys hear that? Team members stop and listen. The distinct sound of a human voice can be heard, albeit distantly. 9A, it's singing? Yeah, that's definitely singing. 9TL, might be coming up on the end, then. Grab your firearms, guys. The sound of firearms being readied is heard. Team moves quietly for a time. Sound of singing increases in volume. 9B, there's a light up ahead. That the exit. Team moves towards opening in the wall. 9TL moves through first. 9TL, Jesus fuck, what SCP-1864-1, translated, good evening, travelers. End log, addendum 2, comprehensive SCP-1864-1 interview, close log. The following interview was conducted after Foundation personnel had set up a direct route to the center of the labyrinth, and a line of communication with SCP-1864-1. The interview was conducted in order to ascertain the origin of SCP-1864. A translator was used to facilitate communication between SCP-1864-1 and the Foundation interviewer. Interviewer, Agent Arnold Tolan. Interviewee, SCP-1864-1 translator, Agent Trevor Wilson. Begin log, Tolan. Alright, I believe we're ready to begin. Can you state your name for our record, please? SCP-1864-1, I am Dr. Heinrich Boff. Tolan, Dr. Boff, you have been classified by our organization as an anomalous entity, and have been given the designation SCP-1864-1, by which you will be referred for the duration of this interview. Do you understand? SCP-1864-1, I do. Tolan, thank you. Can you tell me what this place is? SCP-1864-1, silent. That is difficult to answer, I think. Ostensibly, this is a maze within a pocket of other space. But that is not what you are interested in, I think. Tolan, what is the origin of this anomaly? SCP-1864-1, trickier still. Easy to say, we found it this way, a mining colony that discovered something strange, not in the rocks, but in their own backrooms. Tolan, what was the purpose of the facility afterwards? SCP-1864-1, silence. Tolan, SCP-1864-1? SCP-1864-1, many strange things during those years, Agent. A strange time. The world was changing, and the Kaiser feared we would not change fast enough. Tolan, so then, a military facility? During the First World War? SCP-1864-1, no, we were never military, Agent. We were always men of science. Our dedication was to God and to chemistry. This anomaly was our primary objective when we first arrived, yes, but only proved to be secondary to what came next. Tolan. Which was? SCP-1864-1, ah. Crane's Neck, the Lonely Liar. Little Panhun. Tolan, who was Panhun? SCP-1864-1, was? No, Agent, Panhun was not. Panhun is. Panhun lied to us, told us stories, let us believe a falsehood. The damned little Panhun, who trails off Tolan, is something wrong. SCP-1864-1, a fishing ship for the colony, they found little Panhun in a net, drug him out of the sea. Sickly little boy, but glorious in creation. Those who beheld him could not grow ill. Those who were ill and beheld him were healed. The poisons, Agent, the enemies of the state were ruining us, costing us the war. We saw salvation. Tolan, what happened to the facility, and yourself? SCP-1864-1, Little Panhunt told us he was sent by God, a messenger of peace eternal, to bring an end to pestilence. Make no mistake, agents, there was no shortage of doubters, myself included. But the evidence was staggering. Tolan, that does not explain what happened to the facility, or you. SCP-1864-1, begins to respond in a sing-song voice. Little Panhun, the lonely liar. We put him in a box when he lied to us, and dumped the box into the pit. Can't reach us from the pit, Panhun, your sick eyes can't see us when they're sewn shut. Tolan, I don't understand, SCP-1864-1, ISCP-1864-1, the water keeps Panhun quiet, keeps him put away. Panhun woke one night and was different. There was a change in the air, then. The rest of them. They were angry. Angrier than I. Tolan, you mean the instances of SCP-1864-3 that we've SCP-1864-1, my friends, my family, all. What Panhun did to me was nothing. I am still a man, although a man lost. The rest, you cannot even say that. I put him in the box, sewed his sick little eyes shut, and locked the box. I can still remember the screaming, like. Trails off. Tolan, what about the instances of SCP-1864-3? SCP-1864-1, they want nothing more than to pull Panhun into the darkness with them, agent. I cannot let them open the grate. They do not remember the world above, but I do. They do not know how they would fail. Panhun would consume it, like he consumed us. Tolan, so then, Panhun, what is it? Silence for 30 seconds. During this time, SCP-1864-1 extends its appendage to the pool, where it continues to extend until disappearing. SCP-1864-1 is observed watching the water. SCP-1864-1, something foul that we dragged out of the sea. Something that should have stayed in the darkness forever. End log, Addendum 3, Additional Collected Logs, Close Log. The following information was collected during initial exploration of SCP-1864. What follows is an excerpt from the scientific journals of a Dr. Gregory Grosswald, German scientist during World War I. Translations have been provided where necessary, and irrelevant passages have been removed for brevity. August 15, 1916. A commotion in the market today. One of the fishing vessels pulled a small child out of the ice. Dr. Manns initially declared the boy dead, but discovered he still drew breath. Miraculous, and in no way unrelated to the anomaly of our study, I believe. I will visit the boy when he becomes healthy. August 19, 1916. The boy is pleasant enough, although speaking with him has become an inconvenience. The boy claims that he is called Panhun, but cannot seem to form sentences without switching between a number of languages. Whether this was taught to the child, or a matter of some other nature, is currently unknown to me. Doctors Manns claim the boy is sickly, however, and is not certain if he will last the winter, much less the month. August 27, 1916. Another miraculous event surrounding our mysterious Panhun. All of the patients at the medical center have been released, their symptoms vanishing overnight. When pressed, all of them claimed that Panhun came to them while they slept, and touched their skin. A number said that the boy simply looked at them, and they became well. Dr. Manns is aghast, and I must say that I do not blame him. I have arranged another meeting with the boy, with Dr. Boff accompanying me. We will get to the bottom of this. September 2, 1916. It may be a miracle after all. The boy claims that he is a messenger from God Almighty, and that his arrival will signal the dawn of a new Jerusalem in our country. He speaks of peace eternally, an end to sickness and war, and the glory of Germany and the Kaiser. After seeing the works of his hands, I no longer have any reason to doubt. We will bring this child back to Berlin when the next ship arrives, and we will secure the glorious victory for the fatherland. This boy Panhun will be our salvation.